The simulation on the left shows single component pressure volume and temperature volume diagrams and has been generated using a van der Waals equation state, a cubic equation state, so we can represent an isotherm on the pressure volume diagram or an isobar on the temperature volume diagram. So let's look at the pressure volume diagram that I've selected. And so the blue line represents an isotherm. Now the actual cubic equation is also this dashed line. But of course the physical system is that we connect points of equal fugacity, because this is now at saturation pressure for this temperature. The two green areas are used to represent that if this were on a linear scale, because notice this is log of pressure and log of volume, if this were on a linear scale, then these two areas would be equal. And that's one way of determining where we draw this line across for the saturation pressure. The idea is we can change the temperature and we're going to move this green curve up or down. Here we're showing what is the saturation pressure for this temperature where this line is drawn. And then the corresponding, if I select the temperature volume diagram, then I show an isobar. So same idea, the blue line. We can now not look at the areas as corresponding to anything. And again, the temperature is also represented on a log scale as well as the volume. And the saturation temperature for a given pressure, as we change the pressure, of course, this blue curve is going to move up or down. So now let's look at this simulation. So here's the simulation where we have an isotherm, the blue line, and remember these volumes are equal only if things were on a linear scale. And as I increase the temperature, then of course the saturation pressure here increases, and here are the volumes of the liquid and the vapor at that pressure that are in equilibrium. And I can increase the temperature enough, so there we're pretty close to the critical temperature isotherm, and then we can certainly go above that. And then correspondingly on the temperature volume diagram, this is an isobar, and then the saturation temperature is indicated here, and I can increase the pressure and at some point go above the critical pressure. So this gives you a better idea of how a cubic equation state then is used to calculate conditions for vapor-liquid equilibrium and for the properties of a single component as a function of temperature and volume, or as a function of pressure and volume.